Magnesium. How does magnesium play a role in testosterone? You hear about this thing all the time. It's one of the top three deficiencies in men all over the world. You get your blood test done, you always see magnesium. You've heard about this thing, magnesium Mg2+, for you chemistry people. What the hell is it? Why do you need it? What foods have it? How can you supplement it? How much do you need every day? What's normal values? All in this video. Let's start with one of the most important things that you should know. If you have high SHBG, I actually forgot to cover this in my SHBG video, so I'm sorry about that, but I'll cover it here. If you have high SHBG levels, then you have low free testosterone. You can go read about that in my SHBG video. I've made videos about low testosterone, high testosterone. Go read that. Watch those videos. Please watch those videos. Very, very important for men. Now, if you have high SHBG, it binds to testosterone, the testosterone molecule, and your free testosterone is low, so you're not able to use the testosterone you have in your body. So what matters is not total testosterone, but free testosterone and bioavailable testosterone. If your SHBG is high, then your magnesium may be low. Why do I say that? Magnesium is one of the few ions that has a non-competitive binding to SHBG. What does that mean? Magnesium can actually bind SHBG. So the more magnesium that binds SHBG, guess what? SHBG can't bind to testosterone anymore, and hence you have higher free testosterone. So it is very, very important for you to have enough magnesium in your body. Huge finding in science. Now, basics first. It's involved in the pathways generating ATP, adenosine triphosphate. It is what is energy in your body. When your body creates ATP out of glucose, that's energy, that's calories. So it's involved in this pathway. It's involved in protein synthesis. It's how you grow muscle, by having more protein. It's how your memories are formed, by having protein synthesis. It's happening all over your body. Even neuromuscular excitability. When I was studying acetylcholine receptors during my PhD, I still remember, let's talk about glutamate receptors. So for the glutamate receptor excitability to happen, there's something known as the removal of a magnesium block. So the magnesium ion is literally sitting there inside the receptor blocking glutamate excitability. And when the depolarization happens, or when the membrane becomes excitable enough, the magnesium block goes away, and then you can have the synapse and the connections happening. So magnesium is huge for the body, okay? I still remember learning all this, the neuromuscular junction. And obviously, neuromuscular junction is important for us because for the brain to connect with the muscles, that's how you do a deadlift, that's how you do a squat, that's how you do a bench, that's how you do all the testosterone-boosting compound movements, you know, pull-ups, lunges, and so on and so forth. Okay, normal ranges, based on scientific literature, are 0.75 to 0.95 nanomoles per liter, or 1.7 to 2.5 milligrams per deciliter. Just two different metrics for you. Get your blood test done. Look at the ranges of magnesium for your blood test center. Follow those ranges. If you're low, you need to work on it. I've actually never seen high, like toxic high magnesium. It rarely happens. The body has a way to recycle it. Okay, again, magnesium is one of the top three deficiencies in men. I covered that. Now let's talk about muscle function. The most studied mineral in this regard, in terms of energetic metabolism, okay, for your muscles, it plays a large role in muscle contraction. Deprivation of magnesium leads to higher oxygen consumption. What does that mean? When you work out, when you walk, when you breathe, when you do physically strenuous activities, oxygen is obviously used. The less oxygen you use, the more optimum you are, the more you're optimizing yourself. So the more you can do, the longer you can do it, right? Endurance. We need endurance in bed when you're pounding that pussy. You need endurance in life. You want to, you know, not be drinking coffee all day. You want to go out at night. You want to party. You want to have fun in the morning. You want to meditate. You want to go out there and crush those weights. You want to have sex with your girl. You want to dance. You want to do everything. Go out in nature. Go for hikes. Whatever you want to do as a man, that natural killer instinct, you need endurance. And guess what? Magnesium plays a huge role in endurance. Now, Magnesium supplementation in athletes improves oxygen consumption, how optimal you use oxygen, and energy expenditure optimization leading to improved endurance. I just talked about that. Supplementing magnesium can also improve strength and power. So they measured strength and power in athletes, and they figured out that just supplementing magnesium, for example, with ZMA, and I'm gonna get into that soon, can increase both strength and power. Now, inflammation. This is also a big one, right? When you have a lot of inflammation, you're gonna have belly fat, you're gonna have man boobs, you're gonna not be able to think clearly. Inflammation is just the enemy of everything for us, especially for us men. So inflammatory cytokines, okay, these are chemicals that are correlated with very high inflammation. These are inflammatory markers. They reduce the secretion of testosterone and other upstream, so before testosterone, the precursor of the testosterone, and that leads to the, and which leads to the production of, so any upstream factor like LH, for example, luteinizing hormone, that produces testosterone, inflammatory markers reduce that. They destroy that pathway. So inflammation is bad, very bad. Depletion of magnesium may lead to inflammation, and supplementation or dietary use of magnesium can reduce inflammation. This is scientifically proven already, okay? Magnesium may reduce ROS, this is reactive oxygen species, like free radicals, for example, which cause inflammation, which cause oxidative stress. This is why you eat antioxidants to get rid of all that. And magnesium is one of those antioxidants. A low amount of magnesium has been observed to correlate with increased ROS, free radicals, etc. So if you have low amount of magnesium in your body, go get that blood test done. And you see that low magnesium, that's what's gonna happen. You're gonna have higher free radicals, higher oxidative stress, higher inflammation. Okay, so the higher the magnesium, the lower all that bad stuff. Again, obviously, how, you know, erections and libido. If you have low magnesium and that's causing you to have low testosterone, or at least there's a high correlation with it based on the scientific literature, we know this, then it's gonna affect your erections and libido, especially your morning wood, because that's what testosterone is involved in. The major correlate with testosterone is libido. So if you are having problems with that drive, that passion, that sexual appetite, it may be because of a magnesium deficiency. So please get your blood test done, please. Next, supplementing with ZMA improved testosterone. This has already been proven. It's a 2011 study in the paper Biological, in the journal Biological Trace Element Research. Free and total testosterone both go up, and obviously free testosterone will go up because magnesium has a non-competitive binding with SHBG. I told you about that recently. In fact, just 4 weeks of magnesium supplementation with exercise can increase both free and total testosterone levels. Even sedentary people who just couch potatoes, even they have a significant improvement in free and total testosterone, but the ones who exercise, much greater. All right. Sources of magnesium: green leafy vegetables, spinach for example, nuts, cashews for example, seeds, cocoa, right? I eat 99% cocoa dark chocolate almost every single day with my raw milk at night, especially with honey, seafood. These are the sources of magnesium in food. How many milligrams do you need? Okay. So 420 milligrams per day is what the papers suggest. Okay, this is the evidence. But if you're training hard, take 30 to 50% more. Okay? So 30 to 50% more than 420, so around 600 milligrams per day. 450 milligrams per day is what is in ZMA, and that's magnesium aspartate. Zinc is not aspartate. I made a zinc video earlier and I accidentally said the word aspartate. That's not what I meant. It's for magnesium. So I'm correcting myself here. Any good brand, don't have to mentally masturbate about ZMA. You know, get any good brand and you're fine. And again, more information about magnesium, about increasing your testosterone levels naturally. Everything is down below. Click, have fun, man. Go boost your testosterone. You know, join all of us who have, you know, thank God, found the light, and have found the natural ways of increasing testosterone and getting our life back, getting that transformational change. And again, if you want to get Afro-D, you want to learn more about the Afro-D Academy, all the links are down below. here to help you, man, in any way you want. Got questions, you can post them below too, and I read everything and I'll answer them the best that I can. And again, man, to end, eat healthy. Really, really eat healthy, man. Like, not just to improve testosterone levels, but just for your health, man. Like, how can you be deficient in vitamins and minerals and then work hard and make money and go do your grunt job every day? And it's this mind boggling, it's like you're climbing up trying to get somewhere, but it's like a treadmill and it just never gets you anywhere because you're deficient. So don't be in that grind. Like, really fix your shit up, fix your blood today. And the first thing to do is go get your blood test done, measure everything. Numbers are everything. Numbers don't lie, man. Looks can lie. Words can lie. I can say whatever the fuck I want, but I have the results to prove it. So get your results. And as always, love you, bro. I'll see you in the next video.